This is a privately owned church. It's a place for people to come, just kind of find some peace and overlook the valley here. And the border is due south from us. In the old days, this was a huge smuggling point because the cross lights up and it was a beacon. So they come straight toward the cross. Now they're going up behind the mountains. But again, this is our home. These people have embraced life here in Cochise County, and people enjoy living here. I love it here. And there's 30 other counties on the southwest border that we're on the front line as sheriffs and police chiefs and citizens, our families. And so we've seen that paradigm shift to what it was 25 years ago to what it is today.
I decided to come out here after being on Capitol Hill last week and talking to many members of Congress and seeing that there's a discharge petition going on that Democrats are pushing that could very well grant amnesty and not do anything at all to take care of border security.
We look at border security as a program, not immigration, border security. And that's public safety. What we've done here is we've sent a strong message to the transnational organizations, the cartels, that you will not be doing business in this county. And if you do, and we catch you, and we complement what the Border Patrol does too. We have a great relationship with them. But what the federal government won't prosecute, we prosecute. Juveniles, for example, that are recruited for smuggling. It sounds cold, but let me tell you, these kids are safer in my hands than they are the cartel's hands. All the way to the human smuggling, the modern day slavery. In my county, we're dealing with a very evil element. And we've met that evil element with strong consequences. Don't come to my county. And if you do, we're gonna charge you. If we catch you, we charge you. There are people here from other countries that are here illegally, that do not embrace our American values, that are here to harm you, harm me, and pose that community threat that, I'll be honest with you, causes me restless nights, causes me concern. You and I are held accountable every day to our decisions. It should be no different to anybody else. If you've harmed people and you're a violent offender, why are you in this country? I'm sorry, you have made some poor decisions. And why would we say, okay, now you're an American? My men and women are putting their lives on the line every day to protect this great country and to protect the citizens of my county. For you leaders in this country that say, come to my city, come to my county, and we'll hide you out, you don't know what you're doing to morale in my county. That is very offensive to the American way, what we stand for, our Constitution, all that. And whether they're standing here next to me like you are, or they're hearing it on a radio or hearing it on this video, the bottom line is, go back and read the Constitution. Go back and look at your oath of office. What right do you have? I don't have a right to say, we're gonna ignore this law today. Come on into my county. What gives me that right? Whatever Congress does, they have to keep it consciously in mind, the fact that whatever they vote on, make sure their vote supports and complements public safety at the community level. If they don't do that, all they're doing is dealing us a really bad hand, a real dangerous hand, and it harms our quality of life in our communities. All I ask of my congressional folks from the federal side is really think this out and make sure we're making, and you're making, those right decisions about communities. And that's what this is all about, is our communities. I don't think that's too much to ask from our congressional leaders. And anybody wants to challenge that, come down and see what we do every day. And that is, we've taken a strong stance for what's right to do, not maybe what's popular. We don't do what's popular, we do what's right.